Hi, in this video I will give an overview how you create your own classes and use them in Python. Before I start covering the topics regarding classes, I have created some Python resources. I have created 4 textbooks regarding Python. You find the textbooks, additional videos and additional resources and lots of practical examples on my webpage at this location. The contents of this video is how you create classes in Python, how you use the classes you create, how you can create a Python module, use a Python module, and also I will cover the important topics regarding classes, inheritance. First, I assume you have Python installed on your computer and you can use lots of editors when creating your Python applications. You have the Python IDLE, which is the default and quite a simple editor that is part of the basic installation of Python. You have the Spider editor, which is part of the Anaconda distribution. This is a more powerful editor and very similar to MATLAB. Those who have used MATLAB, Spider is very similar to the MATLAB editor. We have other editors like the PyCharm, Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio, Jupyter Notebook, etc. So here you see the Spider editor, which is part of the Anaconda distribution. If you install Python using the Anaconda distribution, you get the Spider editor, you get Python, and you get lots of additional Python libraries like the NumPy, Matplotlib, etc. So the Spider editor consists of a console window where you can enter your Python commands. You also have an editor where you can create Python scripts or Python applications. And then you can run your script by clicking the Run button. And you can also get an easy overview of all your variables and the values for each of the variable in the Variable Explorer window. So Python is an object-oriented programming language, shortened OOP. And almost everything in Python is an object with its properties and methods. And the foundation for all object-oriented programming languages are classes, which is the topic in this video. And almost all programming languages today use object-oriented programming techniques. So it's important to know about classes, how to create them, and how to use them. Here you see a basic example. You use the keyword class in order to define and create the class. And here you see a basic example. I have created a class called car, which has 2 properties, model and color. And then I can later start using that class or create an object of that class like this. So name of the class is car, and then I can create an object car equals to car, which is the name of the class. This name of the object can be anything. And then I can use the print command in order to find the different properties that is defined within the class. So let's go to the Spider editor, or if you prefer, you can use another editor to create this class and see how we can use classes in Python. So now I'm in my Python editor, Spider, but you can use another editor. Let's start creating this specific class. So I just use the class keyword and the name of the class, in this case car, and a colon, and enter. And then I can define some properties, model, just set them empty like this to begin with. And that's the class, and now we can start using the class. So I create an object of that specific class, car equal to car, like this. And then I can start specify the properties, car, And you see you have IntelliSense color equals to blue or something, and car and model, you can set it to Volvo like this, and then you can print it to the screen, print car color plus and car model like this, and let's just run this program and see what happens. First we just need to save it. I just save it to my hard drive. Just call it examples like this, and let's run it. And as you see, it prints and the color I specified and the model like this. I can just have like this, so it's easier to see. And now I can change it to green like this, and you see it's green and Volvo. And also here later in the program I can change the properties. So let's just copy this thing. I can change the color, I can change the model, Ford. So now if I run it, first it prints green Volvo, and then next it prints black Ford like this. So that's how you create a basic class in Python and use it. You define the class, and then you make and create an object of that specific class, and then you can set and use the properties which is defined inside the class like this. So in this basic example we created one object of that specific class, but we can also create multiple objects. Let's say we set car1 equals to car, and then next here we set car2 equals to car like this. So now we have created one object here and another object here, and then we just change it to car1 like this. And here car two, and then we print information car two like this, and then you can run it and we get the same result, but we have defined two different objects of the same class like this. So the next thing I will talk about is the so-called init function, and in Python all classes has a built-in function called underscore init underscore, which is always executed when the class is being initiated. So here I will create a simple example where I have created an init function within the class. So here the same class, a car, and here I have created the init function. In other programming languages this is called a constructor. So this is a piece of code that is executed when you initialize the class by creating an object like this. So here I have created a class, and inside the class I'm creating this init function, and then I define the two properties, model and colors. And then when you create an object of that specific class, then you can use initialize the class like this by setting the properties which is part of that specific class like this. So let's create this example in our Spider editor. So here is our previous example, we just need to modify it. So I define this function called init. The following input argument, self, which always need to be there, and the properties model and color in this case, like this, and then we can put self dot model equals to model, which is the input argument, and self dot color. Color like this. So now we have defined the class with this init function, which will be executed when we initialize that specific class. So let's now here, instead of having like this, we can have put the properties directly here, Ford, comma, green, like this. And then you can remove those. And the same for the other object you have here. You can have a Volvo, comma, and the color. Black, like this. And then you can remove those. So now we have defined an object of the specific class where we have this, where we initialize the properties, the model and the color, and the same here, and then we just print it to the console window. So let's just run it. Yeah, so you get a syntax error here. I just forgot this colon we always need to have, so let's just run it. And of course, this need to be indented like this. Like this. And now we can run it. And of course, the result will be the same. But now we have used this init function when we have initialized the object. Like this. So now we have created a class, we have created what we call this constructor, and we have two properties. Let's also extend the class with some other function. So let's create a function, or what we call a method, inside the class. So we can create a method called having this print all the time, we can create a method which is actually a function that is displaying this to the screen. So we can call it display car, and the argument need to be self like this, and here we can put this print statement instead. Print, and instead of car here we need to have use this self, and this self parameter is actually a reference to the current instance of the class. Since we can have multiple instances of the class, we need to specify and use this self parameter. So instead of car1 here, we also need to have self like this, and then we can remove this one. We can remove this one, and then we can use this method or function car1, and see you have this IntelliSense. You can select this display car method like this. Since it's a method, it has this parentheses, and the same here for the other one, car2. So now we have created a class, a constructor with two properties, and this function or method, as it's called in object-oriented programming, which we just print the properties to the console window. And then we have created two instances of that specific class, car1 and car2, where we have defined different properties in the init function or the constructor, and then we want to display these properties to the screen. So let's just run it, and you see, and get the same result. And then you can easily change these parameters, and then you get the proper properties printed to the screen like this. You can also modify the properties. So assume in the initial properties in the constructor is Volvo and black, then we can change them. I just remove this one. Let's have just this object. So now it's Ford and blue, and then we print it to the screen. But let's change one of the properties, the color equals to green, like this, and then we can display it once more. In the next line, let's just run it, and then you see first it's blue and Ford, and then next is green and Ford, since we change the color property from blue to green like this. So now we have created a class and used that specific class in Python. So let's have a short summary of classes. And as you see from the code, we have now defined a class called car, and that class has two variables, actually called properties, model and color. And in addition, we have defined a function or a method which we call displayCar. Typically we use the term method instead of functions when we deal with functions that is within a class. And, but you declare the class methods like normal functions, with the only exception that the first argument to that function or method needs to be this self keyword. And to create an instance of that class or an object, you can call the class using the class name and pass the arguments which is part of this constructor. And in Python, this constructor is called init. Typically, in the previous example, we have created an object or instance of that class like this, car1 equals to car, and the input arguments, setting the default properties which is specified within the class like this. So in the example we have created so far, we have defined the class or created the class, and then we are using the class in the same Python file. But typically you want to create the class in a separate file, and then you can use that class in a specific Python script. So let's see how we can do that. So it's recommended that you create your classes or even functions in general in a separate Python files. In that way, you can reuse those classes and functions in many different Python scripts. So in this example, it's the same example, but the definition of the class, we put that piece of code into a Python file called car.py, and then we can use the specific class in one or more other Python scripts. But in order to use it, we need to have on top of the Python script from car, import car like this. So let's create this example in our editor. So this is our previous example where we define the class, the constructor, and the method, and then we are using that specific class inside the same Python file. But let's just copy this, create a new Python file like this, and then save this file as car.py, like this. So now we have created the class called car in a separate file called car, like this. That's the class, and now we can use that specific class in another Python script like this, and then we need to have this from car import car like this. And let's just run it. And you see, we get the same results, but we have just reorganized our code. So the class is stored in a separate file, and then we have another Python file, a Python script, where we use that specific class like this. So that's the recommended way. Always create your classes in a separate file, and then you can use them in multiple Python scripts. The next thing I want to talk about is what you call inheritance. And inheritance is a very important aspect of object-oriented programming in general. And inheritance allows us to define a class that inherits all the methods and properties from another class. So assume we have this example. We have created a class called Person with a constructor and two properties, name and age. And then this method called displayPerson, which just display the properties to the console window. So that's what you call a base class or a parent class. And then we have two different other classes that is inherited from the parent class or the base class. And in order to show that the teacher class inherits from this person class, we just put the name of the class in parentheses like this. So then we put these classes in a separate file, and then we can use those classes in a separate Python script. So we have the parent class called Person, and then we want to create two different subclass or child class, namely Teacher and Student. And then in the parentheses we send we specify the parent class like this. So both Teacher and Student inherits from the Person class like this. So let's create these three classes in our Python editor. So now we are back in the Spider editor. Let's start creating those classes. So let's start with the Person class, the base class, or the parent class. It's almost identical as this car class we created earlier. It has this constructor with two properties, name and age, and it has this method called displayPerson. That's the parent class. Let's create the other classes. Class Teacher, and the name of the Person class in parentheses like this column. And then we start by setting pass. So we use the pass keyword here when we do not want to add other properties or methods than the methods and properties that are inside this base class or parent class. So you just set pass, then the teacher will inherit all these properties and methods from the parent class. And we do the same with the student class. Just copy the code like this and change it to student. So now I have created three classes: Person, parent class, and two subclasses or child classes, namely Teacher and Student. I will save these classes in a separate file called Person. Like this. And then we can start using those classes in a separate Python file like this. So then we just start to have this from Person and then you can import everything like this, and then we can start creating an object of the teacher class. So teacher one equals to teacher like this, and the constructor has two properties here, the name and age. So then let's create a name here, Knut Nielsen, Norwegian name, and the age 44 like this. So this is, now we're creating an object called teacher1 based on the class teacher, which has the following properties, name and age. And then we can use this method, display person. So teacher1 equals to this method, display person. Sorry, not equal here, of course. We have to use this dot and display person like this. So now let's just save it. So now we have created the person.py file here with those classes, and then we are starting to using this teacher class. So let's just run the code. Now this display person method, this just display as stated here, person and the name and the age like this. And then we can do the student. So student one, student, and the student and the teacher are using the methods and properties from the base class or parent class. So we have name and age there as well. So name of the student, Per Hamsun, and the age 20, like this. Here it should be like this, equal, and then you can use student1 and the display person method like this. So let's run it, and then here person Knut Nielsen, 44 years old, which is the teacher, and then we have the student Per Hamsun, 20 years old. We can create multiple teachers or multiple students like this. Student number two, Arne Hansen, age 25, like this. So then we have one teacher and two students like this. So in this basic example, teacher and student inherits the properties and methods from the person class using this pass argument or keyword here. But let's say we want to change the constructor and this add one or more properties, and also we want to update this method. So let's create our own constructor in the teacher class like this. You can just copy this code and change it. So now the teacher has its own constructor, and assume we have in addition to name and age, we want to have grade as a property, and then you can just add that property at the end here. grade equals to grade like this, and we also want to update this display person method like this. And then now we want to display both the name, age, but also want to have the grade here. And then let's change it to the grade as well. I can just copy this one like this, comma, and then we want to have the show the grade as well. So self dot grade like this. So now when we are calling this display person method, we show the name, the age, and the grade like this. So let's save this. And let's run it. Now, before it works, of course, we need to. So now we have updated. This is the teacher. Instead of grade, we can put course here. Course, and then we do almost the same for the student class as well. So instead of course, here we want to have a grade. Like this. So now this is the parent class, showing only two properties, name and age, but the teacher class has name, age, and course, and the student class has name, age, and grade like this. And you just save it, and then we need to update our code here. So we have the teacher, we have the name, age, and we want to have the course as well. So this specific teacher has a course called Mathematics. And then this specific student with his name, age, got the following grade for this Mathematics course like this. So let's just run it now and see what's happening. So when we now run it, this is the teacher, and then this display person method displays the name, the age, and the course, and then the student calling the same method, display person, it has a name, age, and a grade like this. And in this modify example, we have created this parent class called person with this constructor and two properties, name and age, and this display person. But in the teacher class we have modified the constructor and added a property called the course, and we have changed the display person method so we can display the course name as well. For the student class, we have modified the constructor, adding a grade property, and we have modified the display person method, so it, in addition, displays the grade. So now, in this case, this object teacher uses this display person method, and the student object using this display person object. So this is what we call inheritance, and it's the foundation for object-oriented programming and classes in object-oriented programming. So I guess that's all you need to know about classes. Now you know how to create your own classes and how to use them in your Python programs. If you want to learn more about Python, take a closer look at some of my resources. So that's all. So good luck with your Python programming. Thank you.